You might have come across site administrators handling multiple WordPress sites at once. How are these sites handled? Are multiple versions of WordPress installed on their site? In this video, we will see what is WordPress multi-site, and how to set up a WordPress multi-site. WordPress multi-site allows users to create multiple, related sites with a single WordPress installation. You can create any number of child sites with either a subdirectory or subdomain. Multi-site are mostly used to create a centralized system to manage multiple sites at once, by a super admin. The super admin has control over the plugins and themes to be installed on the site. This gives major control on the site, and avoids unnecessary conflicts with plugins and themes installed by other users. So how to create a WordPress multi-site? Although creating a WordPress multi-site does involve handling code snippets, the steps are simple enough to be understood by any non-technical folks. Step number 1, downloading and installing WordPress. The first and most obvious step is to download WordPress from WordPress.org. We have already explained step-by-step methods on how to install WordPress in another article. This article will show you the installation process for a web host server as well as localhost. If you are installing WordPress on a localhost, you can also watch our video tutorial for the same. Find the link for the article and video in this video description. Step number 2, allowing multi-site in wp-config.php file. To enable multi-site on your newly installed WordPress site, you need to start with adding a simple code snippet in wp-config.php file. This file resides on your website's home folder. Add this code snippet just before the line reading "That's all, stop editing." Happy publishing, in this way. Finally, save the file. Moving to step number 3. Configuring WordPress network settings. From the WordPress sidebar menu, go to Tools and click on the Network Setup option. This setup option will only appear in the Tools menu after you've added the code snippet given in step 2, into your WordPress site. First, you need to set up desired network title and network admin email address in the given fields. Once you have configured this, click Install. You are provided with two code snippets that need to be added to two separate files on your site. The first code snippet should be added to the same wp-config.php file that we used in step 2. Add the code snippet just above the line reading "That's all, stop editing." Happy publishing, in this way, and save the file. Next, the second code snippet should be added to .htaccess file, which resides on your WordPress home folder. You need to replace the whole content with the given code snippet in this way. Finally, save the file. Your site is now configured to be a multi-site. You need to log in again to get started. Step number 4. Configuring network administrator settings. After you've logged in, you can notice a My Site's logo on the top left corner of the page. It will list the network admin site and all the child sites that you have created. This is a permanent feature to help super admins access all the sites easily. Only the super admins can access the network admin settings, that allows them to install plugins, themes, and configure other major settings of all the sites. If you hover to one of your child's site, you can see the minimal settings that will be accessed by the respective site administrator. To add a new site, go to Network Admin Settings and click on the Sites link. You can see all your sites listed here. To add a new site, click on the Add New button, and then provide further details like desired site URL, site title, site language, and enter the admin email address. Once the settings are done, click on the Add Site button. To manage all your sites, click on the All Sites link. You can see parent site and all child sites under All Sites dashboard in this way. You can edit, manage, or delete your site here. In this way, you can set up a WordPress multi-site. You can also read the article on this topic on our blog, learnwoo.com. The link for which is given in the video description. But that's not it. WordPress plugins work a little differently in a multi-site environment. Don't forget to watch our next video tutorial to learn how to install and activate plugins on a WordPress multi-site, and how to set it up with WooCommerce. Go follow us on our social media channels, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel for more informative video tutorials related to WordPress and WooCommerce.